It doesn't get any bigger than Bond, and of course you were a part of that wonderful legacy as well. Can you talk about your fondest memories of working on that and why you think Bond continues to endure so remarkably?
Yeah, it is quite remarkable. I came over, my timing was pretty good. It's usually not as good as this. And Britain was knocking out superlative products week after week after month after month. They were right at the very top of their game. I met Barbara Broccoli, and somehow we got along pretty well. You know when you're contacting somebody and you make sense to each other. Well, I think that's what happened. So I got the role of Captain Carter, and it was the third appearance I did for the Bond people. And was with Roger. I worked for both Connery and Roger Moore. Connery you never fooled around with. I mean, things were strictly right down the line, and whatever the script called for, that's what you gave them. Roger, I mean, you really didn't know what was going to happen until the end of the day. He just loved to caper about. He was a good actor. There was no doubt about that. But you couldn't come in the same door that Connery came in with this incredible sort of presence he had. So Roger came in another door. He became articulate. Well, he always was pretty articulate. And he had this immense sort of charm that he used superlatively. So he wasn't doing a Connery, but he had to make up some sort of character that was going to penetrate the movie, and he did, and that's how he survived. I forget how many pictures he did, but it was quite a lot. And he was good. He had that sort of veneer that people in the spy business, the international spy business, had to have. They had to ride over every possible difficulty that came up, and he did. I couldn't imagine who was going to take over that role. And I think maybe the Broccolis are playing it the right way. They don't want to commit themselves. And they're sitting in the easy chair. Everybody is doing their going through their paces. And they've got a front row seat as to who they think. They're the ones who know how the Bond should work. They're the only ones who can do it. So a lot of speculation really doesn't amount to a hill of beans. Whoever it is will be a good one. You can bank on that.